me. I'm sorry. I'm Joan.
I'm Meredith. Can I help you?
Joan Harris. I work here. Worked here. I've been on leave.
Oh, Joan. My goodness. It's hard to believe you just had a baby.
You don't know where I started.
Do you want me to announce you?
No, I'll let myself in.
Are you sure?
No one mentioned a new girl.
I guess they needed someone up here because Scarlett is now covering Mr. Price so that she can do the books with Clara.
Well, now I can understand why I wasn't told.
Oh, my God. My mouth.
Could you just help me with the door?
Oh, he's adorable. Please, don't be mad at me for telling you that. I'm very happy being nobody here.
I know a girl who had your job who ended up with everything.
Joan, you have a guest in reception who needs a signature.
Are you Joan Harris?
Yes, that's me.
You're served.
What? Damn it. Why did you let him in?
He said he needed to talk to you.
About what?
I don't remember everything everybody says.
Because you're an idiot!
Don't talk to me like that.
Do you understand? Having you out here is the same as having no one?
He said he knew you. He said it was a surprise.
A surprise? Well, thank you for that. Here's a surprise.
Joe!
Surprise! There's an airplane here to see you.
You're not allowed to do that.
Come on.
Stop it.
Because before they reach the surface of the moon, they're going to throw down an anchor.
And what if that sinks right into it? Hmm? What if it's quicksand? Am I late for something?
No. May I speak with you?
What's going on?
You got this letter this morning, and it's very upsetting news. Are they firing you?
I don't know.
What does that mean? Breach of contract?
This is from the agency's attorney. Why didn't they call me?
Look at you. You're so confused. You never even met with Commander Cigarettes. I would have known.
It doesn't matter.
I want you to listen to me. I know you're feeling vulnerable, but I am your strength. Tell me what I can do.
You can get my attorney on the phone. And we can't do this.
You're right. Not right now.
Good morning.
What did Caroline say?
They're making lists. Somebody's not going.
Last thing they need is another office manager.
Or another black girl. I'm Roger Sterling's second secretary. Caroline's gonna elbow me out the window.
What are you talking about?
My goodness, Meredith. We should put a bell on you.
Good morning.
What is going on? There are rumors flying like bats around here.
What have you heard?
Nothing from you! Are we going to McCann and am I going with you?
Meredith, sweetheart.
Don't sweetheart me! In a month, you're not going to have an office and you're not going to have an apartment. Do you want to lose me too?
I was going to tell you today you're coming with me if you want to go.
Can I get some Alka-Seltzer?
No. It is not a normal day. Everyone's living in a fright.
You're right. Get Mr. Sterling on the line.
Drive from O'Hare Airport to breakfast with Sears Roebuck Senior Vice Presidents, then the Chicago Ad Club, 12:30 luncheon, 1:30 speech.
I translated your speech into pig Latin.
That was a joke.
And?
And, I've arranged for that package to be delivered to your suite at the Stanhope tomorrow.
What package?
The package from Canada with all the luggage.
She knows about Marie.
She's Megan's mother.
I'm gonna leave you two alone.
Well, I have to.
Yes.
Sweetheart, I have some sad news.
Is he dead?
Don? No. I don't think so. I think we would have heard about that.
Oh.
That said, our secret plan here has been discovered. They know I don't need two secretaries. I'm sorry. I really thought he'd be back by now.
Well, I hope he's in a better place.
He's not dead. Stop saying that.
There are a lot of better places than here.
I'll give you the recommendation he would have. I know you'll land on your feet.
I always do.